once a week with these plants. First thing is I've got to get this water. What I do is I start out with a couple buckets, and that way I don't have to mix the water every single time when I'm feeding the plants. I get some 5-gallon buckets. This usually will last me a whole week. So first thing first is I've got to adjust the pH. Now this, my water comes out a little too high, so the pH usually comes out around 7, 7.5, and I need to get it down to 5.5, anywhere from 5.5 to 6. So what I do is I pour a little bit of the pH down in, and I mix it up. Yes, I'm using a wrench. Mix it up really good. Now, you're going to want to let it set for a minute or two before you go ahead and test it. But I'm going to, just for purposes of the video, I'm going to go ahead and do a quick test. Okay. Now, as you can see, that kind of came out red. So that means it's now too low. You can see the little color-coded thing here, and it's actually between 4 and 5. So that I need to actually now add a little pH up. Now that I've gotten these both adjusted correctly, it took a while, so I decided to cut out the video and get them adjusted correctly. But now that I do, I'll show you. This came out right. Alright, so before it was kind of red, now it's a nice yellow, as you can see. Actually, I don't know if you can read those numbers or not, but it's coming out in between the 6 and 5, so that means it's about 6.5, so perfect. So now that we've got this adjusted correctly, now I'm going to go ahead and add the nutrients. Now I'm using Aquaflakes, and it's a 2-step process. It's A and B, and they react together in the water when you mix them together. So on this one, on the back of all ingredients, or all nutrients, that tells you how much to add in the water. So I've got 5-gallon buckets, and this says 2 to 15 milliliters per gallon. So a tablespoon is about 15 milliliters. Now I don't really want to go super strong, so I'm going to do 3 tablespoons, which is going to be, you know, just about the right amount, about 45 milliliters, a little less than that. And that's about where I need to be for this stage in the growth cycle. So first I add the A. Mix it up real good. Then I add exactly the same amount of B. Set with that. So now I've got a 5 gallons of nutrient water, and I've also got 5 gallons of non-nutrient that is just pH adjusted. And the nutrient or the feeding schedule I've got for the tomatoes and peppers, stuff in the cocoa, basically what I do is I add nutrients one day, I flush it out with just pH adjusted water. That's the second day. And then I don't feed it, or I don't water it the third day. And what that does is it allows for the nutrients to get in there, the plant to absorb it. And then I flush out the nutrients so that way it doesn't build up too much with just water. And then that third day allows the plant to rest and dry a little bit. And especially what happens is after that third day, it's really, by the fourth day, after that day of no watering, it really wants water. So when you add the nutrients, it really sucks up that nutrient. So that's the schedule I'm doing. And there's a couple different schedules that you can look up online and figure out what's best for your plants. I find that that's the best trick for me. So now I've got enough water to last me a whole week, and I do this every Saturday on my day off. So.